Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Pat Summitt Show. Since we last met, the Lady Vols extended and ended a Southeastern Conference win streak. They pushed that streak to 36 wins in a row with a road win in Fayetteville against Arkansas, and then ended that streak with a loss 61-60 against number 9 Kentucky on Thursday night in Lexington. And Pat, if you take a look at the difference in that win and that loss, it was defense. Arkansas was maybe the best defensive performance by the entire team in some time.
Absolutely, Mickey. I thought we really played great defense and we made it a priority, and everyone bought in. And we probably played one of our best games at Arkansas. There's no doubt.
Kentucky defensively, it wasn't like no one was playing defense, but it was like no one was playing defense against Adia Mathis, who had 34 points and hit the game winner.
Mathis had her way, and we didn't respond as well as we should have. And you know, I think this team is going to learn from that particular situation, and hopefully we'll come back and go to practice today and try to figure things out and be a better team.
The longest trip of the season for the Lady Vols is when they fly out on particular years to Fayetteville, Arkansas, to take on the Lady Backs of Arkansas. And Pat, that game was one of those games to where this team had to play well on the road for the first time since Auburn. But Arkansas had played Florida close, they'd played Kentucky close, so you knew it was going to be tough going in as we go to the highlights.
Absolutely. I thought Arkansas was really a very, very strong team, and we knew that we were going to have to really step up and play well, both offensively and defensively.
Ariel Massengale gets things started with a drive and the layup. She's starting to look for her shot a little bit more, isn't she, Pat?
She is, and you know, she can hunt points and she can get to the paint. I really like what her game has meant to this team.
Here, Alicia Manning starts the break, gets it up to Strickland for the layup. Strickland playing in front of half of Morrilton, Arkansas in Fayetteville, and it had another pretty good game. That's two games in a row when she's played in front of family and friends.
She's definitely motivated, and you know, obviously having her family there and a lot of friends made a big difference. I thought she really played well.
Arkansas went 6 minutes and 27 seconds before they got their first field goal. That was a three that made it 14-3. But then your team went on another 11-0 run to kind of seal the deal early in the first half.
And, you know, I just thought our, as I said, our focus was really good. And I think just Shakina being, you know, at home and, you know, having a lot of support really inspired her game.
Here's Sierra Ricketts with a shot being blocked by Ball, but she gets it back and puts it in, but still good defensive effort by Vicky.
That was good defense, and Vicky has really really come into her own and has made a big difference for us in each and every game.
Great touch pass right there from Manning to Strickland for the layup, and at halftime, it was 31-11, Tennessee leading Arkansas as we move to the second half. And kind of more of the same to start the second half as well, except Tennessee started out with a turnover, and I knew you wanted to get off to a good start in the second half.
Exactly, and you know, we have to be mindful of really passing the ball and getting inside, and right there you see Manning doing a good job.
Lindsey Harris gets a layup on the other end down here for two. Strickland there with a putback right there after the rebound. At that point, with 11:55 to go in the game, it was 45-22. Strickland with a turnover. She gets a little anxious sometimes when she plays in front of all that family.
Well, and I think I can understand, but certainly she came ready to play and made a difference for us in this particular game.
Here's Glory Johnson that'll go in and shoot a layup. Glory Johnson has just been playing phenomenally since the lost to Stanford.
Glory Johnson is very committed to this team and very committed to the game. And, you know, she gets in and gets extra shots and is very serious.
Sierra Burdick there with a jump shot. She may have one of the best jump shots, pull-up jumpers on this basketball team.
Absolutely. To be a freshman and come in and do what she has done, and I really like what she brings to our game.
And here's Isabel Harrison, another freshman from Nashville, gets the put back. and Tennessee goes on to win it by the final score of 69-38. And this team may have used a little extra motivation in this team or for this game going into this contest because they were compared to a couple of teams in the SEC. But how pleasing is it for you as the head coach to see them to come out of the gate on the road in the conference with an 11-0 run?
Well, it's great when that happens. And I think this team in that situation really stepped up. And like I said, Strickland was really motivated. And I just think it carried throughout. You know, everyone stepped up and did what they had to do. And it's one of our best outings.
Last year, the Lady Vols bust up to Lexington and somehow came out with a 6-point win against the Lady Wildcats up in Lexington. This year, they weren't as fortunate. Although Kentucky's defense takes a little bit of getting used to, Tennessee had played that defense before, but they fell on Thursday night in Memorial Coliseum 61-60. And Pat, I know going into the game, the coaching staff and the team, they knew about Adia Mathis, they knew about Snowden, they knew about Henderson and Goss. You name it, you knew about it and had a good plan going in, but it's just like that plan wasn't executed.
Well, unfortunately, we didn't execute to the level that we needed to. And I think this is a lesson that we got to come back and get refocused. And there's a lot more basketball to be played in the SEC. And so I think this afternoon when we go to work, hopefully everyone is going to be right where we need to be. And I think just step up their intensity, especially on the boards. Defensively, we've just got to be there all the time. And I think that's going to make a difference with our defense and our board play.
Pat, as we go to highlights, this is a matchup that has so many connections between your staff, Matthew Mitchell, their program. I mean,
there's
too many of them to mention. You have two former Lady Vols that are assistant coaches.
Right.
You have a former grad assistant in Matthew Mitchell. Mickey DeMoss, after she left you, hired Matthew Mitchell as an assistant. I mean,
it goes on and
it has
on.
All kind, that tree has all kinds of branches. But does it mean, is it special? Is it a special matchup for you when you play Kentucky?
Oh, absolutely. It is. And they bring out the best in us, and we bring out the best in them. And that's why we had such a great game. Just wish we could have finished it out.
Shots didn't fall early. Do you think maybe the Lady Vol team might have been a little bit nervous against that pressure?
I think against the pressure and with the Wildcat fans being there and we just didn't get off to a great start. But there's a player right there. Megan, you look at Glory Johnson. Glory Johnson has just been a difference maker on this team.
Tennessee took the lead when Massengale had that breakaway layup. That was at the 10-minute mark, and Tennessee led 20-18. But then Kentucky took the lead and really didn't give it up until late at halftime. As you see, Kentucky's Keyla Snowden here gets their own rebound and puts it back up for two. And the foul there. You just never got into the flow in the first half. What did you tell this team at halftime going into halftime down before?
Well, obviously, we just said we've got to step up with our defense and our board play. Obviously, we did not come out of the timeout like we thought we would. And also, in the second half, you got to give Kentucky a lot of credit because they played really, really well. I didn't think across the board that we finished the way we should have.
Glory Johnson hits a shot in the paint, and then Kamiko Williams gave you some good minutes in the second half. She's going to get a 2-point bucket right here on the right baseline.
And it's good to see her on the floor and contributing for us, both offensively and defensively.
Another player that really played well last night was Vicky Ball. She had 8 points at halftime. Here she goes in for the layup. On the left side, she really played hard last night.
I tell you, that was one of her best outings, and she really made a difference. She took the ball inside to the post and just really attacked, and I really like what she brought to this team.
There was one point in the second half a little bit later where all Lady Vol fans kind of held their breath. She took a shot, was on the floor for a while, but seems she told me after the game she felt okay.
And she did. I mean, I think she came out of that in a positive way.
All right, here's Audia Mathis with the game winner. As they were down one, she got it to go in heavy traffic. And then Tennessee's Kamiko Williams missed a shot at the buzzer. And Kentucky upsets number 6 Tennessee by the score of 61-60. I know it was a tough loss because in those opportunities, when you were down 12 with 7.5 minutes to go in the game and saw them fight back to take the lead,
right,
then had an opportunity to go up 2 possessions, but a couple of free throw misses maybe kept that from happening. And you could look at it that that was a big deciding factor in the game as
it
well.
It was, and that's where we've got to get a lot better. And we've got to get in the gym and just knock down the free throws over and over and over so we are confident when we go into a game.
All right, 61-60 was the final as Kentucky upsets Tennessee. They'll get a rematch in Thompson Bowling Arena on February 13th.